Hello viewers, yes, this is Ranjana ma'am and you are watching Yes. It's my channel as well as your channel. And yes, this time the second part of your report writing for my ISC students. And this is the review. The most common of the reviews are book review and film review. So in this video, I will be helping you with how to write a book review or a film review. Yes, but you know what is coming? If you have not subscribed to my channel up till now, please do. Because I find my non-subscribers are more than my subscribers. So please don't forget to subscribe if the video has been useful to you. It matters to me. And don't forget to press the like button. Some of my viewers say, ma'am says so sweetly that yes, we always give the like button in the beginning only, some of them say. Yeah, please do and share it with your friends. And now, let's start with the review. So with the book review, what are the things you need to remember or need to know when you are writing a book review? In a book review, you have to first read a book very nicely. I would suggest you go for some of the best sellers. And I remember one of my students, when I had given him a book review in my offline tuition classes, so he was he had written The Merchant of Venice. So he told me, ma'am, why can't I write Merchant of Venice? But later I said, okay, you write it. I just wanted to keep him busy and wanted to see his grasp. So he wrote a very nice review. But one thing is it that in most of the grammar books, they suggest don't write something which is in your syllabus. Why? Because that gives the examiner a poor idea about your knowledge. So the examiner realizes this fellow must not have read much books or must not have read any other book than the course books. And that is why he has written this one. So don't let the examiner have a poor opinion about you. Prepare some book. Go for some book, one of the famous ones. Pick up an interesting book. If you are fond of Chetan Bhagat, go for him. If you are fond of the foreign writers, go for them. In our Indian fiction also, in English, there are quite a few, like Amish you have Chetan Bhagat, then Devdutt Patnaik. There are so many. I'm talking of the Indian ones. And you can go for the foreign writers also. Jeffrey Archer. Yes, you have it in your syllabus also. Jeffrey Archer's Gorilla in the Guest Room. He has quite a famous chain of novels. The Clifton Chronicles and all that. Anyway, whatever it is, you pick up a book. Study it well. And one thing keep in mind, book review doesn't mean that you have to write the whole summary of the book. No. A little bit of the plot, but don't write everything about the plot. Why? Because that might give the, what should we say, the secret of the book. If the book has some suspense in it and you reveal everything in the plot, that is not done. Go for the plot in a concise manner. Write about the style of the author, and you can discuss the characters which have stood out. And then, of course, you will be given certain points on which you will write. So book review is not so difficult, but it needs preparation. You have to study a book and write down the review at home. You go to the examination hall and you say, oh, the book review has come and I'll start writing. No, you won't be able to write in that way. You need to know the book, you need to know the author, you need to know the publication, you need to know the price. These are all the things that are important. You need to know about them. And only then can you write a good book review. So for this, I said you need preparation. Because at the examination hall, thinking of the characters and writing, no, not possible. So my suggestion is that always do pick up a book, read it well, and also think of which genre it belongs to. Whether it is crime, go for any. There is nothing particular that you have to remain to the romantic or the social or something. Whichever is your favorite, go for that. If you want, you are fond of detective ones, go for it. But read it well and try to give a review. Review will be your own personal opinion. But this time you have to be aware that your opinion is not hurtful to others when you are writing a review. And what does the author really intend? What if there is any message you feel that the author is trying to give out to society? As a writer, you can talk about that also. What are the merits and demerits? So this will help the readers of this review. Many times now, before buying a book, what do? We go for the reviews made by the readers who have read it. And many times by reading the reviews, we get a fair idea of the book, what it is about. And then if it suits our taste, we buy it. If not, we leave it. While buying a thing also, you must have come across many reviews which help you to think whether this will be a good choice or not. Yeah, I always pay a lot of attention to the reviews and then only I buy a thing. Regarding books also, so if your review is a good one, it will help the readers or those who are eager to buy a particular book. Your review might help them because it will let them know the pros and cons of the book, the merits and demerits. So these are the particular things you need to know in a book. So as I said, go for a bestseller, that because that would also help the examiner to identify the book. Otherwise, if you go for a book which no one has read, I think in one way it is remaining in the safe side. The examiner wouldn't know and he will consider maybe it is okay and give you the marks. But in another case, he might feel, oh, which book is it? I haven't read. So he might not have an interest. And in that case, he might not give you the marks. So everything is there. So I would suggest go for a bestseller and then read it well and then give your reviews. So what type of language has been, is the language formal or informal? What is the style of writing? Is it ornamental or is it simple? Sometimes they use ornamental style, means a lot of heavy words used, and some of them write very smoothly in simple style. So differs, the style of the authors differ. And this is what you will need. So many times, yes, as I told you, the things you need to know about the book is the author. And yes, another thing, how many pages, and then the publisher, and then the price. These are the things you will put on the top. So like suppose One Night at a Call Center, or To Kill a Mockingbird. So these are one is Indian and the other is by a foreign writer. To Kill a Mockingbird is one of the masterpieces. So then underneath it, after writing the name of the book, underneath you will write the name of the author and the publisher, and then beneath it you will write how many pages, and then what is the price. So these are the things you will write on top before you start writing your review of the book. And then in the first few lines will be a little bit of introduction, and this has to be a bit attractive. And after that, what are the points? So you will give a small plot summary, or as we say, a brief storyline, and then you will comment on the setting of this, what is the background of the novel, whether it is it could be related to the freedom struggle, it could be related to some particular incident in the recent times. And then, yes, as I said, you will be given these points, the use of language, then what is the theme about. Character is an important part in writing your review. It is an important point in writing your review. And then, what social message is the author trying to impart through this story? It may have some message, it may not be, it might just be a simple work of fiction with no message. And then you might be given another point where you are to compare this novel with any other novel written by the same author. Or there might be a point given where you will compare this novel with another novel written by a different author, but the genre is the same. Both of them may be related to some social problem, both the novels, but by different authors. So you might be required to give a comparison. So these are the points you will be given, and you will develop your answer based on these points. And as it is, report, 300 words, and yes, 5 least, 7 the most. That is what they say in schools. So your review will be within this span. So, and then in the end, you will give your own assessment, what you have felt after reading this, the merits and demerits of this, your personal opinion. But don't be too blatant, don't be too hitting if you have disliked it. No, don't go for that. Others might like it, so don't be. Yeah, try to keep a middle path. Very nicely point out the things which you have liked in the book and which you have not liked in the book. So this is for your book review and film review. Now let's come to the film review part. Yeah, let's come back to the film review. The film review is also similar. Here you have to think of a movie which you have seen recently and which might have cast an impression in your mind, and then you pick up that movie of your choice and you will make a review of it. So that in reading this review, many people might take it as a help whether he should see this movie or not. So be very impartial, write your own personal points, opinions, but at the same time don't show your bias against it. Very politely point out the flaws or the good points. So what are the things while writing a film review you need to know? So the name of the film, of course. So for this also you need a preparation, because there are certain things you need to know while writing the review. Only name of the film and the plot won't do. So name of the film, who is the director, producer, these are some of the basic points which you need to know. When was it released, which hall was it released, these are some of the things which you cannot bluff. If you are going for a movie, so everyone will know if you are trying to make up something fictitious. So don't go do that. And that is why I am saying you need a preparation, where you will go find out the name of the director, the producer, where it was, which was the date when it was released. These are facts and you can't play with facts. So after acquiring these information, then start writing your review. Like choreography, who is the choreographer, who is the music director, you need to know these. Where is the location, where, and these quite a few things. Just knowing the plot and the hero heroine is not enough to write your film review. That is why I am saying it needs preparation. So prepare a book review and a film review Who knows, it might come. And then you are in trouble. Why? Because there is no choice here. You have to do it. It's compulsory. 20 marks is no joke. So please, please, please prepare. And if you need help, I might put up one review, book review and film review in your, in my blog. I haven't done it as yet. But if you all request, then I can put it in my blog for you all to view. Okay? So let me know about that. I'll find time before your exams to put one up of one of the recent films and one of the recent books. So yes, regarding the actors, not only the major characters but also the side characters you have, the ones who help, they are also of great help, not just the hero and the heroine, the character artists. So you have to know about them. Then which genre is it? Is it a detective one? Is it a romantic one? Is it some social movie, war movie, crime, whatever it is, science fiction, so many, magic, like J.K. Rowling's Harry Potter. So, and then what is the plot? That means summary in brief. And then how have the artists performed in this movie, the major and the minor characters. And then photography, yes, that is an important part. Photography, how did you find the photography? Was it appealing? Was it poor? And then the music, the songs are released much before the movie has been released. You can hear the song, and if the songs are quite good, quite soothing to the ear or whatever it is, if they become popular, then this helps the movie also. People are eager to watch the movie. So what, how is the music, quality of music, the music director, the singers, they all form an integral part of your film review. And then the costume, the makeup, art direction. And as I said, script, is it a powerful one? And then choreography, who is the choreographer? There might be some movies where there is no dance. If it is your choice, then you don't need this point. And you can compare it with other movies of the same type and give your opinion regarding it. And finally, yes, as I said, how much do you rate it, how many stars, or out of 10, what is your rating? This will enable the readers to make their choice whether they would want to go and see this movie or not. So please be impartial, give your opinion about the merits, where it has created an impact on you, the demerits, where it has failed in creating an impact, the places where the movie has suffered, if it is a complete failure, a flop, and if it is a huge success, whatever it is, give a very perfect review. Okay, so I think this is enough, and you need to practice. So think of a movie and then write. It will be very helpful for you, and you will be quite confident while facing the boards. What if a book review comes? What if a film review comes? Nothing to worry, you are prepared. So bye for the time being, and let me know how you liked my video, and don't forget to press the like button, subscribe and share. Bye.